हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव एमसीक्यूज रिलेटेड टू वर्जीनिया वुल्फ। आई होप यू हैव वॉच टू वीडियोस रिलेटेड टू हर बायोग्राफी सो दैट यू कैन नो सम मेजर फैक्ट्स अबाउट हर एंड यू कैन अपीयर इन योर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम एफिशियंटली। टू कवर एमसीक्यूज अबाउट मेजर लिटरेचर पर्सनैलिटीज इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर मेनी कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स, स्पेसिफिकली फॉर UGC नेट एंड MA इंग्लिश एंट्रेंस ऑफ वेरियस यूनिवर्सिटीज़। शुरुआत करते हैं फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन के साथ। वर्जीनिया वुल्फ डाइड इन विच ईयर? यू हैव बीन गिवन सम ऑप्शंस। आई एम टेलिंग यू द राइट आंसर। शी डाइड ऑन 28 मार्च 1941। हेंस ऑप्शन नंबर ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर। In 1941, at the age of 59, she died by putting groggs in her coat pockets and drowning herself in the River Ouse at Lewes. Next question. Identify the text in the following list which offers a fictionalized survey of English literature from Elizabethan times to 1928. We are given here few options, and option number B, Orlando by Virginia Woolf, is the right answer. Orlando is a character from this novel who lives from the early days of the Elizabethan period to 1928. Next question. In Virginia Woolf's To the Lighthouse, the lighthouse does not symbolize which of the following? Permanence at the heart of change, change in the unchanging world, celebration of life in the heart of death, celebration of order in the heart of chaos. Let us describe it. The lighthouse actually symbolizes all the human desires, a force that forces over the indifferent seas of natural world and guides people's passage across that natural world. Yet, even as the lighthouse stands constant night and day, season after season, there are changes in the society, there are changes in the world. The lighthouse is the only thing that remains constant. It remains curiously unattainable, and human wishes keep on changing around it. Human wish change, heart change, but few things remain intact. That is why option number B here, change in the unchanging world, is the right option. Next question. Which of the following was associated with the Bloomsbury group? This is a piece of cake for those who have watched the previous two videos. The answer is option number D, Virginia Woolf. The Bloomsbury group included the novelist E.M. Forster, the biographer Lytton Strachey, the Attic critic Clive Bell, the painters Venice Bell and Duncan Grant, the economist John Maynard Keynes, the Fabian writer Leonard Woolf, and the novelist and critic Virginia Woolf. Next question. Who among the following dismissed Ulysses as a misfire? I'm taking questions from most of the previous UGC NET examination. The correct answer is Virginia Woolf. Out of all these options, Virginia Woolf is the correct answer. One of the most vocal critics of Ulysses was this novelist Virginia Woolf, and she once famously said that she thought the novel was a misfire. Next one is also easy for those who have watched the videos. Shell is a character in Virginia Woolf's novel Mrs. Dalloway, To the Lighthouse, The Waves, or Orlando. The right answer is Orlando. Shell was a brave seaman in this novel. Next question. Which of the following lines by Shakespeare is repeated several times in Virginia Woolf's novel Mrs. Dalloway? I am directly reading the right answer. The right answer is option number B, fear no more the heat of the sun, nor the furious winter's rages. The words came to Mrs. Dalloway, fear no more the heat of the sun. She felt somehow very like him, very like Septimus who committed suicide, the young man who had killed himself, and she felt glad that he had done it, thrown it away. This is a famous composition of Shakespeare. Next question. Virginia Woolf's To the Lighthouse has a triple structure. The three parts are named the following except the sky, the window, time passes, or the lighthouse. The correct answer is the sky. Rest three are the titles of the three parts of the novel. Next question. In a classic statement that inaugurated feminist thought in English, we read, "A woman writing thinks back through her mothers." Where does this occur? I'm directly telling you the right answer, option number A, Virginia Woolf's A Room of One's Own. The legacy relationships between a mother and daughter is precisely what Woolf was referring to when she said these lines: as a creative woman, we think back through our mothers. Next question, in which novel of Virginia Woolf does a painter in the act of painting actually figure as a character? The Voyage Out, The Waves, Jacob's Room, or To the Lighthouse? The correct answer is To the Lighthouse. The character is Lily Briscoe, a young unmarried painter friend of Ramsay's. Next question, who among the following women writers famously imagined the plight of Shakespeare's sister? George Eliot, Virginia Woolf, Irish Murdoch, or Frances Burney? The correct answer is Virginia Woolf. Virginia Woolf invented a fictional character, Judith, as Shakespeare's sister in her essay, A Room of One's Own, published in 1929. So all the watchers of the videos can answer this question in the comment. Woolf's last novel published after her death, what is the name of the novel? Please do answer in comments. Thanks a lot for watching and liking our videos. Please continue watching this channel, and you can also join our online or offline classes. The contact details are given on the screen. Thanks a lot for watching. Best of luck for your exams.